han visto las redacciones de todos estos días y a una temperatura y con un dinamismo muy grande, y espero que en actos como este a mí me van a servir, espero, para que ayudar a comprender este mundo en el que vivimos.
La cultura europea, el espíritu mediterráneo, c'est plus large, on sait maintenant. Il faut découvrir ce côté du sud-est de l'Europe, où on a eu une histoire impossible, une histoire très dure, très violente. C'était l'occupation turque. Les Turcs sont restés là-bas 500 ans, rendez-vous compte un peu. Et puis, il y a des autres cultures, cultures du monde balkanique, la culture russe, culture, et d'autres.
The main problem is that nobody knows what would happen, because now in the past there were everything was somehow predictable. The European Union and Mediterranean countries should give much money to fund research and to fight the digital divide. It's about digital divide, but now they are thinking even more. They are thinking about knowledge divide. Why? Because the only source of prosperity for the country is when you produce something or manufacture something which gives added value. Added value is only given if you manufacture knowledge-intensive product.
The main idea of this presentation deals with marine transportation based on optimization approaches which can provide increasing efficiency of marine shipping and growing economy of marine countries, including countries of Mediterranean and Black Sea basins. No doubt that we should consolidate our scientific industrial cooperation in the framework of Mediterranean Black Sea region for mutual benefit and for decreasing negative factors of current world economic crisis.
To find solution, to work together. This is the meaning of this Euro-Mediterranean social dialogue. In fact, this is how ourselves are doing. They work together and find solutions. So that's why I said we do have to learn from nature, to learn from our own selves. In conclusion, I think that by functioning together, the government and the scientists will definitely find the best solution for faster economic recovery and for giving back to citizens the fundamental rights to a high quality, decent and respectable life.
In parallel with attraction of Spanish companies to Azerbaijan, taking into account a favorable conjunctive, it is necessary to study and possibilities for investment in Spain. Here is a big interest in attraction of new investment, including from Azerbaijan. I get with me 12 proposals from different companies of Azerbaijan for cooperation, in future cooperation. And I think so I give this material for you.
It is necessary to brainstorm the future way of what where we should develop, and we as a government servant need to listen what the academicians will advise us, and of course communicate this to the government, to the business community. So I'm at your disposal, Mr. President. I'm very eager, keen and willing to promote relations between Spain and Azerbaijan, between Barcelona and Azerbaijan. I'm looking forward to your proposals, and if you study the proposal that will be submitted by Professor Guzmán-Ayres, please do know that in Madrid we're expecting and waiting for your ideas, and I think we can help render any assistance.
We're still behind the term information age. We still even when our labels, economical labels, measures and comparisons, they still count on those codes and the standards of the industrial age. While we left standard age for 30 years, I think it's time to move forward to make the world information age real in the economy. And I think the economy, your respectable academy should play an effective role in this, encouraging collaborative research, especially from the Mediterranean area, from Egypt, Tunisia, Algeria. We have many guys there.
Creating this policy should forget all the legacies of the past, give up all the post-colonial patterns, and look with new eyes to the world that resolves around the Mediterranean, the revolution in progress in North Africa, but also to the emerging role of Turkey, also to the increasing explosive Israeli-Palestinian question, also to the presence of an intransigent state like Iran, also the precariousness of the situation in Iraq, till to the power of the commercial attraction that China, and India have on the countries of the Near East. On these points, it is possible to build a sound policy in the Mediterranean region, and it is a task to which Europe cannot fail, because if it would not, in a few years, would become marginal in the world balance, with all consequences this may entail.